Dharmendra Pradhan ji, Honorable Minister of Education and Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Sri Ranjan Mahapatra, Chairman, Skill Development Institute and Director HR of IOCL, esteemed board members, faculty colleagues, staff and students of the institute, esteemed guests who are participating both physically as well as in virtual mode, members of the media, both print and electronic, ladies and gentlemen, I cordially welcome you all to the inaugural program of the Rishikulya Hall of Residence and the Pushpavari Lecture Hall Complex. We named this lecture hall complex after the ancient Pushpagiri University, which existed in the first millennium in this very land in Jajpur district. We take inspiration from the past existence of that university, and this institute is going to offer education in a holistic form considering the education system of the land. We named the hostel as Rishikulya Hall, another important river of this land, which is known world over for the olive ridley nesting at the confluence, at its confluence with Bay of Bengal. As you may be aware, IIT Bhubaneswar has been experiencing a very steep growth. The position was not so good in the past, around up to 2015. But from 2015 onwards, we have been experiencing a steady growth. We have moved up in the ranking systems to figure in the first few of the second generation IITs. We have plans to go forward further and become one of the cream of the globe. So in fact, in that direction, recently we changed the vision of this institute to offer education and research at global best. So that's a very challenging vision indeed, but this institute is resolved to make that dream realized. At the moment, we have the second highest intake of students, and our BTech strength is highest amongst the second generation IITs. We have been establishing research centers of excellence. Let me name one of them. Our climate science group can predict the cyclones 5 to 6 days in advance, at par with IMD and at par with the institutions across the globe, reputed institutions across the globe. We're also creating other centers of excellence in a similar way. They're also coming up. Center of Excellence in Augmented and Virtual Reality, Energy, Water, and we have about 10 areas where we would like to excel. This institute likes to excel. During the pandemic, the institute has offered best of education in an uncompromised form through a lot of innovations. And we also served as an example. That's what we could do from this institute, and which the nation can feel happy about. Today, we are delighted to have Sri Dharmendra Pradhan ji, Honorable Minister of Education, amongst us. This institute is not new to him. In fact, he was responsible for bringing President of India and Prime Minister of India to this institute. And we could have both of them visiting in 1 year, which has almost never happened with educational institutions. So we must profusely thank him for giving us this, showing this kind of affection towards us and making that possible. He was also the chief was the chief guest our ninth foundation day. This apart, he has been gracing this campus a number of times and has a lot of support for this institute. I don't have to introduce Sri Dharmendra Pratanji. He showed his leadership from his student days. So he was a student leader from early age with Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad. He served as the Minister of Steel, so Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, and now the very important portfolio of Minister of Education, a large ministry involving a lot of educational institutions and the whole education system of the country. And we felt very happy when Honorable Minister was accorded with this portfolio by Honorable Prime Minister of India. I would like to once again congratulate him for taking up this very important job. Please join me in giving a big hand. He has been very responsible in bringing up several innovations while serving as the Minister in Petroleum and Natural Gas and other ministries as well. Programs like PEHAL, the Prime Minister's Ujjwala program, etc., had a lot of hard work put by the Sri Dharmendra Pradhanji. So I would like to profusely thank him for being amongst us on this day. His program has been very hectic. I request on behalf of everyone, I request him to grace the campus again with some leisure and spend some time with us. Also, we are glad that we have Ranjan Mahapatraji with us. We are going to exchange an MOU with the Skill Development Institution very soon. In a short while from now, before Honorable Minister Ji going to address all of us. Jai Hind.
Good morning, friends. Professor R.V. Raja Kumarji, Director, IIT Bhubaneswar. I'm told lot of people are connected through technology, through digital mediums. So I hope my good friend, Sri Rajendra Prasad Singh, Chairman, Board of Governors, IIT Bhubaneswar, will be somewhere in this program. Sri Ranjan Mahapatra, Director, Human Resource, Indian Oil Corporation, and Chairman, Skill Development Institute, Bhubaneswar, Member of Board, Faculty, Staff Members, and my dear students, and other dignitaries. My greetings to all of you. It's a very important day for me, though I have visited IIT Bhubaneswar several times. As our director was mentioning, I came here for several times in your Foundation Day program. When Honorable President came to the campus for your convocation, I was there with him. And Honorable Prime Minister came to Bhubaneswar IIT for dedicating this august prestigious campus to nation. I was there with him. And some other occasion I visited IIT Bhubaneswar. Well, it's a pleasant day for me for two reasons. IIT Bhubaneswar is in Odisha. The IITs are of international character. It's not only national institutions. Nowadays, since decades, our IIT have come up to the standard of global need. If IIT Kharagpur student Sundar Pichai is not only an inspiration, not only a symbol of our achievement, certainly it's a big contribution of IIT network of our country to the global technology process. So I am proud Bhubaneswar IIT, though it's a second generation IIT, is doing good both academically and in its infrastructure facility. Putting up infrastructure facility of global standard. I'm here today to dedicate two important part of this infrastructure project. 800 capacity boys residency is named as Rishikulya, the important river of Odisha, and this august building, the Pushpagiri Knowledge Center, Pushpagiri Lecture Building. And I congratulate the IITians, especially the Bhubaneswar IITians, its faculty member, its teaching staffs, non-teaching staff. I am confident this institution is going to fulfill the need of our country, need of the world, need of the civilization. The second happy moment for me, till last month, I was in charge of petroleum and natural gas industry of the country. In those days, today, we all are going to dedicate another important campus, which I mentioned just now, which Ranjan Babu is the chairman, Skill Development Institute. From here, I'll go there to dedicate the new campus. And it's a very pleasant day for me. There is a MOU signed between IIT Bhubaneswar and SDI Bhubaneswar. This synergy is expected to create 21st century requirement. How IIT can be complement the skill ecosystem, being tied up with IITs like institution, how SDI will come up to the expectation. These are the primary thing might be in the MOU. Some days back, the engineering pass out student from Burla Engineering College, another prestigious institute of our state, with the help of SDI Bhubaneswar, he did not join anywhere as a employee. He started his own startup. Through that network, he prepared a young group. those who compete for a young innovator competition organized by NASA, and they stood third. A boy from Burla Engineering College, taking help of SDI Bhubaneswar, competing the global competition and stood third. And two raw boys of Odisha, a boy and a girl. Girl was ITI pass, and boy was a street mechanic of a cycle repairing shop. They can envision, they can be part of a rover technology mission. Friends, I am happy, I am confident, I am thrilled of this kind of synergies. And in future, this kind of network, this kind of institution will fulfill the need of the society. And fortunately, due to the visionary leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, after 34 years, we have a new national education policy. Just before coming to the dais, I was asking director and other colleagues from the institution, what about the multidisciplinary new curriculum in your institution? He just assured me, IIT Bhubaneswar is in a process of doing the multidisciplinary, multidimensional facility in this campus. Friends, I'm here, the students, friends, those who are in the different part of the country due to this pandemic situation, due to this COVID-19 pandemic, the normalcy is gradually coming back. Now we have a vaccination just few days back. When I was talking to some important ambassador, when I mentioned India has completed 550 million vaccination doses we have already given, he was astonished, because his country's population is much lower than that. This is India, this is our size, this is our scale. This new national education policy is going to put a red carpet, put a new roadmap. Today, the youngsters, those who are in the campus, their age might be 19, 20, in that category. Today we are celebrating 75 years of independence in our country. By next 25 years, from here to 2047, we will be completing the journey of independence at 100. And it's a nice coincidence, the state this institution is placed, Odisha. Odisha is going to complete its 100th year of new administrative unit on the basis of language, basis of Odia language. After next 15 years, we'll be completing our 100th year of past linguistic based state. That means, friend, from here to next 15 years, from here to next 25 years, when I'm talking in IIT, I'm thrilled, I'm happy, I'm confident. Those who are in the age group of 20 today, by next 15 years, they will be 45, 35. By next 25 years, they will be 45. Just imagine a scenario, by next 15 to 25 years, those who will be in their age group of 35 to 45, they will be the natural leader of the society. Somebody will be the prime minister of the country. Somebody will be the top scientist of the country. Somebody will be a top researcher of the country. Somebody will think about the new logistic model of the country, new methodology of the country, new medicine research of the country. Friends, there is a new national education policy. There is a pandemic-like challenge in front of humanity. And here is a great institution. And from the societal point of view, from policy point of view, I wish this IIT Bhubaneswar should flourish in a bigger way. You should serve society. You should serve mankind. You should serve India. You should serve my native state, Odisha. This institution's success. Gone are the days. Now we are in the Industrial Revolution 4.0. We don't have a place in last past Industrial Revolution. The second Industrial Revolution 2.0, we were the manual workforce. In the Industrial Revolution 3.0, we are the senior executive. But friends, in the Industrial Revolution 4.0, we have to the new wealth creator, we have to the new captains, we will create new global orders from the Bhubaneswar IIT and the IIT and educational campuses of India. With this hope, on behalf of society, on behalf of our country, on behalf of Odisha, I welcome you all again in Odisha. Enjoy your span in Odisha. Its cuisine, its literature, its flora and fauna. From here, the Mangala Jod is the nearest place. Do you know? Lakhs of baht, crores of baht, millions of baht are coming from Siberia every year to this Mangala Jodi near your campus. 30 kilometers high of this campus. Now we are talking about drone logistic network. Just can we correlate something? The Mother Nature has created ecosystem from Siberia to Chilika. Can IIT Bhubaneswar think about a drone-based logistic network to solve the energy consumption pattern, serve the traffic congestion problem, create new jobs, create new convenience, create new economy model? I hope you will be successful. You are already successful. You will be successful. Lord Jagannath is here to bless us, and you are in a historic place. Never forget about this Baruni Illok. Friends, this is the site where our countrymen two centuries ago, fought a heroic battle to uphold the prestigious of our motherland. And I am emotional today, being the in charge of education sector of country. This is the first visit of mine to an educational campus, and it's nice coincidence. I'm thankful to Professor Dr. Raja Kumarji and entire team. You all have given me opportunity to visit a temple. Yesterday, when I landed in Odisha, I visited Bakula Vanavidyalaya, the epicenter of freedom movement in Odisha, and Pandit Gopabandhu Das and his five friend Panchasakha. And I hope, I suggest Dr. Raja Kumarji, you are in the foothill of Baruni. You are just nearby Bakula Vanavidyalaya. You have to take care of these institutions. They are not only old institutions, they are not only old thing to be remembered. They all were scientific. Just imagine, 800 years ago, 900 years ago, this land has built Konark, this land has built Puri temple, this land has, this architect of this state has built Lingaraj temple. How can we correlate with IIT's network and this kind of monuments? How can we prepare ourselves for the sustainability of the globe? Prime Minister Modi has envisioned, has created a global architect, Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure, CDRI. I was talking to the DG, the present DG of CDRI, and I advised him to contact Professor Raja Kumar, IIT Bhubaneswar. Odisha is a cyclone and disaster prone state. My understanding, you have a course on marine science. I am told somebody, when I was going back to Delhi in a late night flight, I met a youngster. He introduced himself with me few years back. What compelled you to come to Bhubaneswar? Sir, I had visited IIT. He told me few years back, in the marine oceanology, IIT Bhubaneswar has some activities. Can we relate that kind of academic network to this CDRI? Can we research about the oceanology new sustainability challenges? We have to plan. Can this Bhubaneswar center be the answer to the global sustainability, especially blue economy challenge, marine challenge, subsea mineral resource challenges? We should plan, we should think about that also. I am happy, I am confident. This lecture building, in future, somebody may remember, some people came together on the 20th August. August is a month of new thinking. August is a month of revolution. Now, time is here to think about this basic requirement of the society, and always academic institutions have the answer, has the answer. I wish all the success of this institution. With this hope, I congratulate the entire IIT network and IIT Bhubaneswar, Dr. Raja Kumarji and entire his team and students friend. All the best wishes. Thank you, friends.